In this video, we are going to overview the options available to define your proposed ground levels in Kubla Cubed. Before you start watching this video, it is important that you understand how construction phases and the calculation order work in Kubla Cubed, so please watch that video first. Before we define our proposed levels, we would have already defined our existing levels. And almost always, we would have also defined topsoil stripping in the next phase. Now we create another phase to define our proposed levels. Now we have a phase for our proposed levels and we can start defining them. To do this, we click on the plus button and we add elevation features. We will see a list of the feature types that we can add. These two are mostly used to define topsoil stripping and construction thicknesses. We will cover those elsewhere. These are used to define proposed elevations, and they are what we are discussing here. We will go through each of these elements in detail in other videos. There are different ways to define the proposed levels depending what information you have available. For example, in this project, we have contour lines that define our proposed levels with an outline around them. We can therefore define the proposed surface with a feature surface, just like for the existing terrain. I will load a file where we have done this. If we edit this feature surface, you can see that we have defined the outline of the earthworks area. We have defined the contour lines. And we have also defined two brake lines for the edge of the road. Once we have defined proposed levels, we will see shaded areas to display cut and fill. Now we can switch into 3D. The default colors are red and blue, with red for cut and blue for fill. These colors are darker where the cut and fill is deeper, and paler where it's shallow. We can also see earthworks volumes in this table. We can use the cursor to check cut and fill at any location. For example, here, fill is 0.74 meters, and here, cut is 0.6 meters. If you are not able to see the cut or fill by your cursor, then you can change your cursor settings. You can choose what is displayed next to your cursor here. I will now demonstrate another way that we could define the surface using a combination of other earthworks feature types. I will delete this feature surface and we'll switch back to 2D. Now in this example, we have two flat areas. We have a sloping area between them. And we have a road. Now in this case, I could use two platform elements for these two flat areas. I right-click to complete, and I will change my level to the one I want to. I click on Enter and add another platform. All right, click to finish. And again, I change the level to the one I want to. Now I will add a slope element to connect the two flat areas. But before I do so, I will make sure that snap points is set to boundary points. So I click on plus, click on slope, and start drawing my slope. Right click to finish. Now I will choose a path to define the element of the road. So I click here. Right click to finish. I will set the width to the one I want to, which is 8.5. And I will change the elevations manually. So that was the last one. I click enter. Zoom out and switch to 3D. So this was a different approach to define the same thing. There are a few details, such as those two points that were here that I haven't added, but we could define these with additional elements. And for these pawns, we could use two additional platform elements. The best option to use depends on the information you have available in your site plans. The most common situation for contractors doing a takeoff from drawings would be to use a single feature surface. However, for designers, it is perhaps more common to use individual elements to build up the proposed levels. So this was an overview of how to define the proposed levels in Kubla Cubed. Please see our other videos for more detailed information about the individual feature types. Thank you for watching.